Hi everyone, it's Alice, and it's that time of year again, where it's time to do another book purge. I feel like I'm doing this at a great time because I literally got 2 comments today asking if I was going to do another book purge soon, and I had already planned to do it today, so it's pretty perfect. Now I do one of these once a year-ish, like a big one, and I always do it in spring because 1, spring cleaning, and 2, there's a school nearby that does like a yearly flea market fundraiser type thing, and whenever they send out information about donations, I'm always like, yes, come get some books, because I have a lot. The school uses the money to fund like extracurricular activities for the kids, which is great, and they're coming to pick up the stuff in a couple of days, so I really need to get on it. So let's get started.
All right, so I'm gonna start over here, and I'm gonna try to like go through my shelves fairly quickly this time, because every time I do a book purge, it always ends up being like a million minutes long. So I'm gonna try to do this a little bit quicker this time. So we're gonna start here. I'm gonna keep all of these John Krakauer books and this one. I'm gonna keep this. It's one of my favorites. This is also a fantastic book. I'm gonna keep these, but I think I am gonna get rid of this book. I've had this book for ages and I did read it and it was really good, but I'm never gonna read it again, so it's time to let it go. I also think I'm gonna let this book go because I've read it and I just don't really feel like I need to keep it. I don't remember a whole lot from this book. I've only kept it because it's such a beautiful copy, but you know, I don't have room for it, so this can go to someone else. I'm gonna keep these books, and then these small ones I'm gonna keep because they don't take up too much space. And then here we have my photography books that I'm gonna keep, and like some interior design books, and these ones. I'm just gonna leave these alone. Now, this shelf is arguably my most messy shelf. I always put like new book hauls and stuff on top of these shelves, so these are all new books that I can't fit on my shelves. So probably not gonna take much of a look at these, but I'm gonna go through these shelves. So here I'm actually gonna get rid of this book because I got this as a gift like ages ago because I'm a huge fan of Game of Thrones, but honestly I'm not that interested in reading any of the other books other than like the main ones, which I have here. So I'm actually gonna get rid of this book. I know someone who would appreciate this, so I'm gonna give it to them. And then I also actually think I'm gonna get rid of this one because, again, honestly, I'm just not gonna read it. It's also like so big, so I'm just gonna keep the main series and keep waiting for the 6th and 7th book if they ever come out. The rest of the stack here I am going to keep. I'm gonna keep this book because it's a graphic novel. I actually want to put this somewhere else, but I'm gonna do that later. On this shelf though, I'm gonna keep these two because I haven't read them. These ones I think I want to keep. I'm gonna put them here so we can take a look at them. I actually think I'm gonna get rid of this book because I've read it and I'm never gonna read it again. It's really good, but I don't need to keep it. But these ones, I'm gonna keep. The rest of the books on the shelf, I'm gonna keep. Especially this one, it's beautiful. Still need to read this one. Love this book. Need to read. I've had this for ages, and I never seem to be able to, like, let it go. But I'm gonna keep it still, because I still want to read it. And then here, I have some cookbooks that I'm gonna keep. And then this one, I'm also gonna keep because I wanna read it. On this shelf, I don't think I'm gonna get rid of anything. Some of these are my favorite books. Some of them I still need to read. Obviously, not gonna get rid of Lord of the Rings or this one, which is one of my favorites. But maybe we can find something here. I actually don't think we can. I'm gonna keep all of these. These are like my F. Scott Fitzgerald books. And then these two I still wanna read. Wanna keep this. Need to read this. You know how it is. I'm gonna keep these. And then I don't really know if I have anything here that I want to get rid of. I think here I want to keep everything. Little Fires Everywhere is one of my favorites. Still need to read some of these, and so I want to keep them. Some of them I've had for a really long time, and I can never seem to like want to get rid of them, and I'm just gonna keep them. The same with these. I still really need to read this one. It's a beautifully illustrated book. And then here, I think I'm just gonna keep these books as well. Moving on to my main shelves, I feel like maybe we can find some stuff here. I have, like, taken a look at my shelves several times over the past few months and, like, gotten rid of stuff. So there might not be that many this time, but we're just gonna take a look and see what we can find. On the top here, I have a lot of, like, my classic books, and I'm just gonna leave these alone. But then I also have some at the top here that I'm also just gonna keep because I wanna keep them. And then we have, like, more classics and all of that, which I'm gonna keep. These ones I'm gonna keep, as well as these ones, and these poetry books. We've then got my Persephone books collection, which I'm of course going to keep because Persephone books is one of my favorite publishers. I love these gray editions, and I also like these editions that they have, which have like illustrations on them. We have The Secret History, never gonna get rid of that, and then these Vladimir Nabokov books that I'm gonna keep. Then we have more like classic stuff that I'm probably just gonna leave alone. Except, actually, I think I'm gonna get rid of this book, if I can get it out. This is a beautiful, beautiful edition of this book. But to be honest, I have read a little bit in this, and I'm not that interested in it. And this was sent to me, actually. And I think I'm just gonna get rid of it, because I don't think I'll ever return to it. I am gonna keep the edition of Frankenstein that they sent me, though. Frankenstein is one of my favorite books, and this is a really cool edition, so I'm gonna keep that. And then the rest of these I'm also just gonna keep. Actually, I might be lying. I am gonna get rid of this book. This is a small like essay from Elif Shafak. Love Elif Shafak, but like I read this and it was fine, but I don't really feel like I need to keep it, so I'm gonna get rid of that. And then this I'm gonna keep, I think. Moving on to the part of my shelf that is like hidden by the doors normally. This is always like the messiest parts of my shelves, but we're just gonna take a look here. On the top here, I have The Man Who Died Twice by Richard Osman. I'm gonna keep that. I also have this book. This is The Hit List. I'm pretty sure this book was sent to me, and I've heard okay things, but I do have a lot of, like, mystery thrillers that I need to read. So I think I'm actually gonna give this to a friend, and then if I really want to read it, I can just borrow it back from that friend. I also think I'm gonna get rid of this book, actually. I enjoyed this, but I didn't love it, and it's actually quite similar to the Thursday Murder Club series, and I prefer that series over this, so I don't think I'm gonna keep going with this necessarily. It's a fun, like, cozy mystery, but I feel like I don't really need to keep it. Again, I could just give it to a friend that I think would like it. I'm gonna keep these books. This is one of my favorites. These ones, I think I'm gonna keep, except I'm gonna get rid of this book. I talked about this book in my last Purge, and I, like, kept it, even though I was wondering if I should get rid of it. Oops. And, you know, still haven't read it. Now it's time to just, like, get rid of it. I lost some books in the back here, but I'll get them later. These ones I'm gonna keep, and then these ones also I'm pretty sure I am going to keep. I just noticed that this book and this book are not together, even though they're in the same series, which is my bad. I always get questions about how I organize my books. And if you've watched a lot of these, like, book purges, you will have noticed that I don't organize my books. I just, like, put them where they fit. On the next shelf, we have this book, which I still want to keep. It's a book in Norwegian. I'm gonna keep these books, Alice in Wonderland, I'm gonna keep, of course. And then here, I think that I want to keep most of it. Actually, maybe I think I'm gonna get rid of this book. I've had this book for, I don't know, like 3 years, and I still haven't read it, so I think that I can just get rid of it. I need to, like, get it out, though, which is a struggle. This is a nonfiction book, and honestly, I just don't really feel like I need to keep this. I actually have an ebook copy of this book, so if I want to read it, I will just read that. Moving on, we have Convenience Store Woman, which I'm gonna keep, and then this is a Norwegian book that I'm gonna keep. And then here, I think we're just gonna leave all of this alone. On the bottom shelf, I have some of these books that I couldn't fit anywhere else that I want to keep, and then I have like a bunch of like coloring books that I'm gonna keep. Then I actually think that I am gonna get rid of this book. Honestly, I don't want to read this. I haven't read it, and I just don't want to. I think the three first books in this series are really, really good, but I've heard so many mixed things about this one that I don't think I want to keep going with the series. I think I'm just going to keep the first three, which I think are pretty solid, and then this one, it's such a chunker. I'm never going to read it, and a lot of my friends who have the same taste as me, like, really didn't like this, so I'm going to give this to someone that I know, maybe, and I could always, like, borrow this from someone else if I decide I want to read it. Then, these I'm gonna keep. These I'm gonna keep. This is a really cool book about maps. We have this one, which is great, Hunger Games, and some of my, like, YA fantasy series that I'm just gonna keep. Moving on, we have got more classics. I'm gonna leave all of these books alone. These are my Murakamis, which I'm just gonna leave. There's a gap there because I lent a book to someone. More classics. Honestly, I don't want to go through these, so we're just gonna leave them. And then here, we have these translated classics that I'm gonna keep. I don't actually know if they're classics, but they're translated books. We have The Song of Achilles, which is great. The Silent Patient, I'm gonna keep. And then these ones, I've gone through these books several times, and I haven't gotten any new ones since I did, so I don't think I want to get rid of any of them, so I'm just gonna leave them. These are like nonfiction books. Maybe I want to get rid of something here. I actually think I'm gonna get rid of this book. I've had this for, I'm not even joking, I think I've had this for like 8 years, and I don't think I'm ever gonna get around to reading this, honestly. I keep thinking that I want to read the book before I watch the movie, which I never watched. And yeah, I think I'm just gonna get rid of that one. And then I also, actually I want to keep that one. I think maybe I'm gonna keep the rest of these. And then these ones are like short story science fiction collections I'm gonna keep. Ninth House, obviously gonna keep. I finally read this book and I loved it. Then we have Dead Poets Society, which I'm gonna keep and read at some point. My Penguin English Library Collection, I'm just gonna keep. These books are absolutely beautiful and I'm just gonna leave them as they are. I'm also gonna keep these books. These are some of my most beautiful editions. These are like poetry collections and the covers are just wonderful. We have this copy of If We Were Villains, which I still need to read, and then another copy of The Secret History, which I'm gonna keep. Moving on, we have another messy shelf. This is a Norwegian book that I want to keep. This is one of my favorite books that I want to keep. I might actually get rid of this one, or I don't know, maybe not, actually. I might keep that one. I'm gonna keep these, I'm gonna keep this, and this, and God, I have a lot of books. I'm gonna keep this book on Agatha Christie, but I'm gonna get rid of this book. This is a Norwegian book about evolution. Honestly, I really like this book, and I love this cover, but I'm not gonna read it again. It's pretty basic, so it's not really a book that I feel like I need to revisit. So I'm gonna get rid of this one and maybe it'll make someone else happy. These I'm gonna keep. This one I'm gonna keep, even though I don't know if I'm gonna like this book. I just want to read it. And then the rest of these I am gonna keep. Then we have The Maidens by Alex Michaelides, which I want to keep. We have a book by Graham Norton, which I want to keep because I want to read it. These ones I'm gonna keep because I still need to read some of these, and then some of them are my favorites. This is one of my favorite like nonfiction books about archaeology. It's really good. I actually think I might get rid of this book though. Even though it's Margaret Atwood, And I love Margaret Atwood, and I want to read more of her books. I don't actually think I want to read this anymore. I've heard really not great things about it, so I'm going to get rid of this one, and then, you know, if I want to read it, I'll, like, find it somewhere else, I guess. But yeah, this has got to go. On this shelf, I don't know how much we're going to be able to get rid of. I'm going to keep these ones. These are beautifully, like, illustrated books. Gonna keep these, this one. Actually, I think I can get rid of this book, finally. I've had this book for ages, and it is about a topic that I'm interested in, but I've had this book for like 10 years, and honestly, I just don't think I'm ever gonna get around to reading it. I am a little bit undecided about this one, so I might put this on my nightstand for like a month and see if I get around to reading it, because it is a topic that I think is really important, and I've heard really good things about this book. But if I don't read it within like a month, I'm just gonna get rid of it. Then we have Things in Jars, which I'm gonna keep. These ones I am going to keep. Still wanna read a lot of these. I have so many books that I want to read. Gonna keep this. Still really need to read this one. This book, though, I think I can get rid of because it was sent to me, and honestly, I don't really know if I'm that interested in it. This is a crime book, and I'm gonna give this to one of my coworkers who really like crime books, and she can tell me what she thinks. And if she likes it, she can give it back to me, and if not, she can just keep it or get rid of it, obviously. I'm also gonna get rid of this book, actually, because I've read parts of it, but I don't think I'm gonna read the rest of it. This is a book in Norwegian that was written by two guys who made this podcast that I really like, but then, you know, I feel like I started reading this book and I've read parts of it, but it's very much just what they talk about in their podcast, so I didn't really feel like it offered up that much more. I also, sadly, these guys, good for them, but they moved their podcast to, like, a thing that's behind a paywall, and I don't want to, like, subscribe to that just to listen to their podcast, so I'm gonna get rid of this, and then maybe one day I'll start listening to that podcast again. Then we have some books here that I'm just gonna leave alone because it's The Handmaid's Tale, which I love. On the bottom shelf here, we have these books that I'm gonna keep. We have this book, which I feel like I said I was gonna get rid of last time, and then I guess I just didn't. I don't really know why I kept this one, but it's gonna go this time, I think. This is a really good book about, like, crime technicians in Norway, but I don't need to keep it. Then these ones I am gonna keep, except this one. This is also a book that was sent to me, and honestly, I've had it for so long, and I don't think that I am gonna read it, and I'm probably not gonna be able to get it out. Didn't do that very successfully, but I'm gonna get rid of this book. Again, this is actually a book that I have an ebook version of available that I can read if I wanna read this book, so gonna get rid of that. Need to fix that later. Then we have these books that I'm gonna keep. These are some of my, like, favorite graphic novels. I'm actually also gonna get rid of this book. This is a Norwegian author who's, like, she, like, rose to fame with her first book, and then this one came out and nobody seemed to really like it that much, and this was sent to me and I just lost interest in reading it after reading a lot of not so great reviews. I really did a number on the shelf, like, they really fell back there. This is also a mess now, and it's all just a mess. Moving on to the final shelf. We have a lot of stuff on the shelf, so we're just gonna look through all of this, I guess. On the top here, we have these books that I'm gonna keep. This book, which I wanna read, but I'm afraid of. Really wanna read this, love this book. Wanna read this, this. This one, though, I'm gonna get rid of because I've had it for ages, and I don't think I'm gonna read it. This is an ARC. And even though it's an interesting topic, again, I just have too many books, so I'm gonna get rid of it. I'm also gonna get rid of this book. I've had this book for ages. You probably all know how popular this was back in the day. I'm never gonna read this book again, so I'm gonna get rid of it. This one I'm gonna keep. This one is a book that I've kept for ages because it's such a beautiful book. I read this book and I think I gave it like 3 stars. And I just kept it because look at this edition. It's so good. But I'm never gonna read it again. So I'm gonna get rid of it. Finally. Please be proud of me, someone, for getting rid of that book. The Way of Normal People that I'm gonna keep. Gonna keep this one and this one. This one I am gonna get rid of. I had an idea for like a video that I wanted to do with this, but then I need to read a lot of books for that video, and so I'm just gonna like put a picture up of it if I need to like mention it. I am gonna keep this one because it's beautiful. Then here, I think I'm gonna keep all of these. At the end here, I'm also gonna keep these books, and then here, maybe we can do something here. These are all of my Phryne Fisher books that I'm gonna keep. These I'm gonna keep. Here though, I should maybe be able to do something. I'm gonna get rid of this book, actually, because I read it and I actually really didn't like it, even though I really like this author. This one was not it for me, so I'm gonna get rid of that. Gonna keep these ones. Still really need to read this. Gonna keep these and probably all of these as well, except maybe this one. I think I'm gonna get rid of this book, even though it's beautiful, and I also got it in New Zealand, so I have sort of like nostalgic feelings about this book. I read it, and it was fine. It was actually pretty good, but I'm not gonna read it again, so I'm gonna give this to a friend. Then we have Factfulness that I'm gonna keep because I really, really want to read it. Gonna keep these ones because I want to read them. Gonna keep that because it's really good. Probably gonna keep all of these. And then here, still really need to read this book by Malala. Good God. I've had it for ages, still haven't read it. One day I will, hopefully. And then, to be honest, I took a look at the shelf not too long ago and I got rid of a bunch of stuff, so I think I might actually end up keeping most of this. Still really need to read this one. It's really, like, short, so I never get rid of it because I still think I'm gonna be able to read it. So I'm gonna leave that alone. And then these ones I am all going to keep. On the next shelf we have all of my Agatha Christie books, which I'm gonna leave alone. I also have this that I still need to read. This that I am gonna read soon because Celeste Ng announced that she has a new book coming out. So I finally feel like I can read this because I still have something from her to look forward to. Doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, but you know what I mean. I'm gonna keep this one as well because it's really good. This one I'm gonna keep. This is a book by Caitlin Doughty that deserves a better place than this, but you know, you can see that my shelves are really full, so I have some space issues. Gonna keep this. Really need to read this because Emily St. John Mandel is also coming out with a new book soon, and I should get on that. I'm gonna keep these, I'm pretty sure, and then these books by Maya Lunda I also want to keep. Then on this shelf we have this book that I'm gonna keep, as well as these ones. I just need to read them. This is a really fun, like, comic strip book. I feel like my graphic novel collection, I'm just gonna leave as it is. Gonna keep this one, and these ones are really good. This is also a great book. I think, again, it's not too long ago since I, like, looked through the shelf, and these are, like, my poetry books. And I usually don't go through them too closely. I think I'm probably just gonna, like, leave these alone. At the top here, though, we have this book that I want to read. And then we have Dearly by Margaret Atwood, which I need to, like, fit on the shelf, but I haven't been able to fit it yet because I never look through these books and get rid of anything. But I'll make room, maybe, at some point. We've made it to the last shelf, actually, and I feel like I have done all of this very, very quickly, but I'm very happy with myself that I managed to do it. I'm gonna keep this book, and this, I think I'm gonna get rid of this book, though. I just, like, I've kept this book because it's beautiful, but I've had it for so long, and I never, like, when I look at this book, I never think, oh yeah, I really need to read that. I just think, like, oh yeah, that's there. So I'm gonna get rid of this book. And then I also think I'm gonna get rid of this book. I've had this book for a really long time, and I, you know, I've had it for so long, and still, again, I haven't read it, and I think that I'm probably not that interested in it, to be honest. These ones I'm gonna keep, I think, but then I think I'm actually gonna get rid of the bottom book here. I've also hid some books behind here, so that's great. Oop! I'm gonna get rid of this book because whenever I go to London, I never, like, take this with me or anything. This book fell down, which I'm gonna keep. I'm also gonna keep these books. And then here, I'm gonna keep this book. It's great. Still need to read these ones. Gonna keep these, this one, and this one, and these ones. All of them, basically. And then these are some history books that I'm gonna keep. I love these books by Robert K. Massey. I'm gonna reread them one day. And then this is How to Give Up Plastic, which I should learn how to do, so I'm gonna keep this. So this is the aftermath of this little process that we've had together, and I feel like this is pretty good. I have been very good at, like, going through my shelves regularly and getting rid of stuff, so this is a smaller purge than you may have seen in the past. But, you know, I still feel like we did a good job. Also, I do have this box here, almost filled with books that I've, like, I haven't had time to donate yet, and so I'm just gonna do it now. A lot of these are books that have been sent to me that I'm not interested in, and, you know, I've just gone through my shelves and gotten rid of stuff, so I feel like we did pretty good.
I'm gonna go box up all of these books now, and I also remembered that I have a couple of books in my bedroom, like a little stack that I'm also thinking of donating, so I'm gonna put those in as well, and yeah. That was kind of it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and as usual, links to my Patreon and other social media will be in the description if you're interested, and I will see you soon.